Well, Russia's grip on parts of Ukraine is tightening with further attacks on key cities. Our correspondent Amelia Adams has the latest.
Ukrainian officials say these peace talks have failed to deliver what they were after, a ceasefire. But both sides did agree to create humanitarian corridors to get civilians out and aid in under limited ceasefires. But the war rages on, and today more than 30 civilians were killed in an airstrike in the northern city of Chernihiv. It hit homes, schools, a kindergarten. There have been some key advances too. Putin's army moving in on Kharkiv in the northeast, the tanks rolling through there.
We do not have electricity in whole city. We do not have water supply. We do not have sanitary system, and we do not have heating. Only natural gas supplement is left. And it continues for 1 day and a half. So we have continuous shelling for 26 hours. 26 hours they are destroying our city.
Russian forces now occupy the southern port of Kherson. That is a big strategic victory. And another key port city, Mariupol, is under siege by Putin's troops. Concern too over a convoy outside the capital, Kyiv, with reports those military vehicles and troops may be waiting for logistical supplies before launching an assault on the capital. And while the peace talks may bring a slight reprieve, there's been a chilling warning from Vladimir Putin. The Russian president says his military operation is going exactly to plan, warning the worst is yet to come.
And Prime Minister Scott Morrison has taken part in urgent talks on Ukraine in the early hours of this morning after the US president called a snap meeting of the Quad Alliance. We'll go live to Canberra and our political reporter Fiona Willenfee. Good morning to you. Things are moving very quickly this morning. What's happened?
Well, Davina, this was a very last-minute meeting, and it was not only about the war in Ukraine, but also about what it could mean closer to home. There are growing concerns for our own region and what China might be considering doing to Taiwan as it watches how the West responds to Russia's invasion of Ukraine. Joe Biden called for this meeting of the Quad, which is an alliance between the US, Australia, India and Japan. Scott Morrison dialed in at 1 a.m. from Sydney, where he's isolating with COVID. And afterwards, he said in a statement the talks come at a critical time for our region and the world, saying we cannot allow what's happening in Ukraine now to ever happen in the Indo-Pacific. We are resolute in our commitment to a free and open Indo-Pacific region where smaller states do not need to live in fear of more powerful ones. Here's the Defence Minister and the US President.
We're very worried about this compact between China and Russia, this unbreakable friendship as they describe it. And the Quad is a very important coming together of Japan, India, the United States and Australia. And it's a commitment to peace and security and stability in our region.
If we act swiftly and we act with courage, we can change the dynamic the world is moving toward. If we don't, we're going to be in real trouble.
Now, today the US announced further sanctions against Russia, taking aim at oligarchs and others close to President Vladimir Putin. It is thought that Australia may follow suit, as we have been in lockstep with the US on these issues. Davina?
OK, Faye, thank you.